do we agree that the goat was killed?
Yes.
His blood was shed.
Yes.
And sprinkled on the altar. Is that not correct?
There was something, yeah.
Okay, good. When Jesus says, I am the Lamb of God, my blood will be shed for all of mankind once and for all. Can you not see the similarities?
Let's have a look. I'm pretty sure it's a goat.
Yes.
Let me double check.
Yeah.
Okay, let's have a look. Let's see the goat.
Okay.
Right, chapter
17. Okay, so...
Okay, right. So...
The Day of Atonement.
Yeah. Zachitu. The Lord spoke to Moses. So this is Leviticus chapter 16.
Yeah.
The Lord spoke to Moses after the death of the two sons of Aaron, who died when they drew too close to the presence of the Lord.
Yeah.
The Lord said to Moses, tell your brother Aaron that he is not to come at will into the shrine behind the curtain, in front of the cover that is upon the ark, lest he die, for I appear in the cloud over the cover. Thus only shall Aaron enter the shrine with a bull of the herd
for
a sin offering, and a ram for a burnt offering.
All right. So you're saying...
I'm trying to find the lamb.
Do we agree that the goat was killed?
Yes.
Blood was shed?
Yes.
And sprinkled on the altar? Is that not correct?
There was something, yes.
Okay, good. When Jesus says, I am the Lamb of God, my blood will be shed for all of mankind once and for all. Can you not see the similarities?
Well, here we have a goat, then you have a person claiming to be a lamb.
Was his blood shed? Jesus' blood shed?
You tell me, was his blood shed?
Yes, he was.
In a literal sense, was his blood sprinkled on an altar?
Right, so the law was pointing to Christ. I can bring that scripture.
When was his blood sprinkled?
His blood was shed.
When was it sprinkled?
And the spiritual implication of that was that that blood was accepted as a sacrifice for all of mankind, once and for all.
First of all,
the same way, the Day of Atonement operated, yes, Jesus fulfilled that law by shedding his own blood once and for all, rather than a goat or a lamb's blood being shed.
But the blood was not sprinkled on an altar. You need the blood.
But the altar, where is the altar?
In the temple.
Where is the altar? Is that the real altar?
Yes.
Right. What was it typifying? Yeah, what was it a symbol of, the altar?
It wasn't a symbol of anything.
It was.
It was a place where God said, this is where the blood needs to be sprinkled.
Where does God live now?
God is omnipresent.
Right. God lives inside of us. We are that altar. As we believe in the Savior and accept Christ as our Lord and Savior, yes? As we believe, he comes and lives inside of us. What is going on? What is going on?
Yo, you're a preacher. You're a big guy. You should deal with it, man.
Nah, man.
You never chat about Jesus like that.
Nah.
You chat about Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Bang to the face.
But that's the difference between me and you. I don't need to get violent about nothing.
Bro, you got all these big muscles.
It doesn't matter. It's not about muscles. It's about love, forgiveness, and mercy.
Do you love him?
Yes, I do.
Even though he says Jesus is a dog.
It doesn't matter. He's a sinner that needs Jesus as his Lord and Savior.
Jesus died for his sin. You're the crusade to the
precisely. Well done. You're learning something.
Seriously, did Jesus die for him?
Yes.
You know the Crusades would have chopped him into pieces.
The Crusades had nothing to do with God.
Oh.
Yes. It was all about religion and politics.
No,
that's
religion.
Not what.
Religion.
It's not about. Jesus is about relationship.
This is amazing, man. They're having a good time. That's why they wear masks.
Why you lied?
Oh, where is it? Oh yes.
Somewhere else.
Yeah, my voice. Yeah.
Ah, okay. But you want like a quick wrap up on what the short discussion was about?
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah. That's true. That's a good idea.
What's the discussion about? It's a little wrap up.
Just a wrap up.
It's a little what happened in this conversation.
This is my Jewish brother, and I love him. I do. I really do love him. And there is a difference between the law and the spirit. I just want to make a clear definition. The law was a schoolmaster to point to the Savior. So where the Jews used to kill a goat, sprinkle the blood on the altar, that was a type and a symbol pointing to the coming Savior, Jesus Christ, who would die and shed his blood for our sins, past, present, future. The law has its purpose, but the law doesn't save you, it doesn't restore you, it doesn't bring you closer to God. In fact, the law brings you under the condemnation of death because you can't keep it in its entirety. It was there to teach you the attributes of God. It was never meant to save you. The Ten Commandments is good, but it was never meant to save you. Never. It was never designed to transform you. Jesus' blood was. The law was a tutor until the Savior comes. That's what the Bible says. So we love our Jewish brothers. We love them to the max and we bless them, but we say that Jesus is the end and the fulfillment of the law. The fulfillment of the law. And we now are justified by faith, not by works, not by the law. By faith in Christ and what he did on the cross, where he died, shed his blood, and has risen and lives in glory with the Father, mediating and interceding for all of us because he's qualified to do so because he shed his blood. As we place our faith in Christ, the power to be transformed, to be healed, to be delivered, to be saved is in Christ. God bless you.
Pastor Michael, let me put it here so you can have freedom in your hands. There you go.
So Alex has said the usual love speech that we hear from the evangelicals of the modern era, and it's very cute and cuddly, but it doesn't really have any substance to it. The idea that the teaching of the law, that the law of God, the instructions of God, do not restore people is simply not true. We see in Psalms chapter 19 that the Torah of God is perfect, it renews life. The decrees of the Lord are enduring, they make the simple wise. The precepts of the Lord are just, they rejoice the heart. The instruction of the Lord is lucid, making the eyes light up. The fear of the Lord is pure, abiding forever. The judgments of the Lord are true, righteous altogether. And I could go on. And I advise everyone to read Psalms 119 to understand just how incredible the Torah, the law of God is. So, there is no mention anywhere in the Tanakh, or as you call it, the Old Testament, that Jesus is going to come around and he's going to do something, he's going to die for people's sins. It doesn't appear. This is just the usual Christian ideas that we've been hearing for the last 2,000 years that are not backed up by the true and holy scriptures, the Tanakh.
Thank you. Thank you, Yosh.